In approximately 1850, when the dresser was new, come midnight, the dresser folk had nothing much to do.
So one night they put their heads together, came up with the answer, and ever since everybody on the dresser's been a dancer. So kindly take your partners, the dresser dance has begun. Come skip and hop round the working top with a 1, 2, 3 bun.
As we gaily trip the light fantastic, all our cares we forget.
Avoiding the rolling pin, we waltz a minuet. Pally glide on military two-step, quadrille the lancers. We swing and sway till the break of day, the dresser ballroom dancers. So kindly take your partners, the dresser dance has begun. Come skip and hop round the working top with a 1, 2, 3, 1.
Herr von Cuckoo, dashing as a white sergeant, jives to a gentle gavotte.
No one can fault Mr. Salt as he saunters,
and at the foxtrot Miss Pepper is hot.
So kindly take your partners, the dresser dance has begun. Come skip and hop round the working top with a 1, 2, 3, 1. Come skip and hop round the working top. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1.
Herr von Cuckoo seemed a little happier, but Miss Pepper was bored with the singing and dancing. She thought it was old-fashioned. If only something new and exciting would happen, she thought. And then it did. As Herr von Cuckoo hopped back to his cuckoo clock, he found something behind the rolling pin. He whispered to the others to come and look. They saw a small brown man lying there, quite still. Who could he be? The dresser folk had never seen him before. Mr. Salt nervously touched his arm. It was warm. Suddenly they realized it was a gingerbread man. The big ones must have baked him before they went to bed. Mr. Salt and Herr von Cuckoo gently stood him up, but he was all rubbery and fell over. Then they noticed he wasn't finished. He had no face. The dresser folk decided to give him one. They searched the working top for things to use and found some currants for his eyes and nose and a large red cherry for his mouth. They sat the gingerbread man on the rolling pin and carefully pushed the currants and the cherry into his biscuity head. They made an excellent cheeky face. But he still wasn't moving. Miss Pepper suggested a way to wake him up. Mr. Salt twisted her grinder and a few ground-up peppercorns dropped out. Miss Pepper picked them up and held them under the gingerbread man's new nose. The pepper made him sneeze. The sneeze made him wake up. Waking up made him curious. He slowly stood up and started moving his arms and legs. Then he jumped in the air with delight. The dresser folk introduced themselves and told him where he was. The gingerbread man said, "Hello," and started shouting it over and over again and leaping all over the place. "Hello! Hello! Hello! Hello!" He nearly knocked over a plate leaning against the back of the dresser. The others were worried. They didn't want the big ones to be woken up by the noise. Suddenly, the gingerbread man spotted a sort of box with knobs on. The others gasped with horror as he flicked one of the knobs. Music started blaring out of the box. Very loud music. It was a transistor radio. The gingerbread man started leaping up and down in time with the music. Miss Pepper smiled. This wasn't boring. This was fun. She started dancing too.